coastie I've seen before.
Hi everyone, and welcome to another video. Now this video should have been a live match for the Black Diamond because we fished here last Saturday. But unfortunately, after filming for 4 hours and only having one fish, I binned it off and never got the camera out of the bag for the second half. So what I've decided is I basically got my margins wrong. I'm a great believer here. I'm going to play you the clip in a minute. But on the open matches, they throw a feeder over. So I believe that there's some big fish in the sides. So straight away, I fished up and plumbed up at side of 23. Straight in with some corn and some micros, about 3 foot deep, and got one. I'll play that clip now. Right, good morning everybody. Welcome to another video. We're here at Lodge Farm. I'm pick 24 on the field lake. And then I tried short, and then I went shallow, and I was just going nowhere. I felt as though that Brendan were going to win the match, just exactly the same as he did last year on his bomb and pellet approach. Robbo had drawn the same peg, the only difference was he didn't fall in this time. And I had come fourth with 60 pounders, what's exactly the same as what this video were here. So what I've done is I've come back and I want to try both margins, but this time I want to feed micros and corn down one edge and dead reds and ground bait in the other. And I just want to see. I plumbed up to start with, and I was in about 2.5 foot of water, but it was too deep. It was just far too deep. Got it completely wrong. I pride myself on my margin work, and I just got it wrong. Ed went, so I don't mind admitting that I got a bit mardy, and turned camera off, and that rate done dusted. So I noticed later on in the match, they came in to the real shallow. There were fish, just natural, they came in. You could see them. And I plumbed up again, ended up in that much water. All right. So whatever that is, about 12 inch, just under, just over, whichever. And I fished corn and micros, but I can't help thinking that in depths like 12 inch, you want maggots and you want ground bait. So here I am today to try and suss it. So next time we come next year, I can hit the ground running and I can beat Brendan Simpson. It seems as though he's getting unbeatable at the minute. So I'll show you how I prepare my micros and I prepare my ground bait. Right then guys, so for, I can't make it any simpler. So all I do for me ground bait is I get whatever I get out of this bag. So it's one. Two. Three. And whatever cup you get for that, you add the same amount of water. So one. Two. Three. And a bit. And all you do If you look there, it looks absolutely disgusting. But the thing I've found with this is it takes on more water, and when you've done this, you'll need wetting even more. You forget that, all right? And then, so if we come back to the ground bait, as you can see there, look, it's took no end of water on. Oh, this is just a case of mixing it up, really. You could put it through a riddle. I don't really bother. Because all I'm going to do is make a little ball, put it in my pot, send it down, done and dusted. So that's ready. Done and dusted. And then with your micros, don't worry, these are feed pellets. They are fishery feed pellets. It's just that I ripped the bag. No, thank you. And all you need to do there is wet them and leave them in water. They will swell and they'll take on that water. All you do, pour some more on. Right. So, groundbait's done, just wait for my micros, they're done. Well, I'll show you how I've plumbed up. Right then guys, so what I've got, look, is I've plumbed up, I always have the body of the float out of the water, and I aim to look for a bit, something just a bit square like an house brick, something. Now, it lifts up there, but it does drop back in here. Right, so we're gonna try that. So that lifts up, so I don't know what that block is, but if you look there, I'm gonna try and avoid that block. So you look there, so it could be a root or something. So what I'm going to do is pass there a bit. So let's just have a look. Now ideally you want to get your hand in and get it sorted, but a lot of fisheries don't allow gardening. You can't have that. So what I've got to do is you've got to make the best of your bad job. So what's this like here? So I'm happy with that. Well, that's a bit. Happy with that bit there. I don't like that. That's. It's not there. It's just a rock or something. So I'm gonna fish. I'm gonna fish it behind there. That'll do me. So if you look there, I've got my float, 0.5 a gram float. I've got so many, 5 or 6 number 8s to anchor my float down. A 4-inch hook length with a size 12 Guru. I think it's XS, that one. So I'm happy with that. Let's introduce some bait. Right, for down this edge, what I'm going to do is I'm going to get these three fingers, put a nice little ball in, and then just a sprinkling of dead reds. Right, there's one coming in and I can see it. It's coming in. Didn't take too long. Foul up to him. Ooh, story of my life. Here we go. They're a bit spooky at the minute. Got all that bait wafting about. Right. Let's see. I've left plenty of float on show for camera. Little dink then. There's two carp there. Look. There they are, that's in. Are they big fish? So you want decent elastic. This is that MAP TKS stuff, the white stuff. I'm not sure the grade. But when I'm playing my fish, pull that back. If you want to get him out of where you've just got him from, you don't want him going back and ruining it. Get him up in the net. Done and dusted. That's it, 1-0. I should have really put my bib and brace on, to be honest, because my legs are going to be wet through. 7, 8 pound. Oh, yeah, look, there's there already. So, I'm just going to lower it in and see if I can get one straight away. And again, look, there we are. Oh, he's gone. Right, he's a bit. Some of them like to get on that leg, and I don't like that. He stayed low in. So he could be fouled. Every fish behaves different. I think it's either right around his fin. Or it's fouled. I knew it were when it behaved. When it behaved when it came out. No, it's in mouth. Oh God! A bit smaller than the last one, but welcome all the same. I don't really like laying food on fishers' backs. Foul up one there, look, that's what happened. So that's foul, I've seen that, it's in tail. So that's the problem when you're feeding already. And I very much doubt I'll get this out, to be fair. I'm on hard into nothing with this one. So I'm expecting float to whip back any minute. But you never know, might be lucky and get one out. I told you. Right. They're there, aren't they? That's the problem. Let's try. Sometimes it can be better to spook them to reset your trap. That's the. That's a big fish there. That's a very big fish, I can see. I'm not lucky enough to catch them. One there, I can see it. Patient. Now you don't want to put too much feed in, because if you put too much feed in, it just causes a feeding frenzy and you end up with liners and foul lookers and everything. So what happens if I got a load in, then I'll probably over wet my ground bait, so it'll like a slop. So if it's a slop, what tends to happen is then there's just a cloud, there's no real feed in it. I think you need like 0.5 gram of a float to hold it better. Now they seem to have disappeared now. A big ghost are coming in here. Right, there's no fish there whatsoever now. So what I'm going to do is just come back to feed again. They come to the feed, so you've got to give them what they want. Big fish that. I could tell that way how much elastic's pulling back. Always try and tuck your pole tip into the side as well. Because sometimes pole tip over the head can spook them. Is that fouled? That were a big fish, that. I can't help but feeling that will foul up. Yeah, it's under its belly. This is where it goes to the moon and loses me. Ooh! That's not good. Jesus.
If he goes under that next platform, I'm going to lose the lot. So always make sure you have enough pole behind you to carry it off. Foul luck to big fish. It's no good. No. I've got 22 lines straight through. There's no gears up for it, it's just where the fish is. It's a low. It's a good 9-10 pound this. I'm fouled in belly. There's only one winner here and it ain't gonna be me. Let your elastic do its work, let the elastic tire the fish out. If all else failed, I'd get down to my top kit and I'd just point the elastic and the thing. You're not going to break your top kit, at least the elastic or the line's going to go. And you may even get the fish back in. Very unlikely, but you never know. Then when you get back down, take a couple of lines off, but hold it so if it does make another one like that, you can just go back out. If only it went like this last Saturday, I'd have been happier. I'd have kept Brendan at bay. I've got to be careful because I want him closer to net him. But I don't want him too close to get either round my keep nets. There you are, told you. As soon as I lift that landing net up, it gets off. So that's giving me an important notice. The fish aren't there. Does the ground bait not hold them enough? I'd probably say yes, it doesn't. I've got to feed again to get back in. Yeah, that's what I want to do. I want to move the camera. I want to fish this side for some micros and corn, see what happens. The reason I've chose this side for the micros and corn, because it's about probably 6 inch deeper this side. Let's dip it under water again. Thank you. That's a nice mirror carp.
Right then, ladies and gentlemen, I've invited my mate down, Brendan Simpson. Say hello, Brendan.
Hello.
Now, you won Saturday's match here. What peg were you on, Brad?
What's the last peg, Greg? The
Robbo
one before last.
Robbo were on 38.
37.
So, how did you win it then, Pa?
Most of the way through the day, I fished bum and pellet quite slow. I did try shallow and other bits, but it was only bum and pellet that really gave me any results. I didn't get anything shallow. I'd say I probably had £60 on the bum and then finished in the margins.
Is there anything special you do with the bum? What bum is it you use?
20 gram.
One of them Preston IC?
Yeah.
S or M, whichever?
ICS.
ICS.
Yeah.
And then what about your length?
I always start sort of 12, 15 inches. If I get a lot of funny lines, a lot of little bangs, then I might shorten it. Probably the shortest I'd go to is about 8 inch.
Right. So when I fish bum and pellet, I leave it at 12 inch and that's it. That's it, me done.
Oh, no, I will shorten it.
Right. What's the shortest you'll go to? Is it 8 inches you shorten?
8 inch.
What size hook?
14 with an eight mil pellet.
Always 8 mil. Do you ever go down to 6 or 4?
Yeah, I would go down if it's a smaller fish venue.
I get you. Do you fish double pellet on the band or not?
No, just a single.
Right.
I think it replicates everything else.
So you feed the eights.
Yeah.
Via catapult.
Yep, catapult. Usually aim around about 14 metres. Then if I see the signs, I can try shallow over it.
Get you. And how many kilos will you feed in a match?
It really depends on the bites. Worst case, probably do 4 or 5 bags.
Right. So you're busy with it then?
Yeah, always busy.
So then your margins, more or less same as this?
I fish corn over, what do you call them, micros.
Same as this side, what you're doing now?
Yeah. Well, I'd have probably reset the trap by now because I've had a few in.
You've had a few bites?
Yeah, I'm going to reset that. I was lucky though, Greg. I was up the end, the wind was blowing.
Oh, but don't forget, Robbo, we're M-peg.
Yeah, but that the way it was pegged, his peg was went into a triangle and he'd lost a lot of the open water.
Yeah.
Although it was black in his margins, I wouldn't have liked to have fished them. Every bite he had just pulled him straight into the reeds. Ghosty, I've seen him before.
I think that's just wet my camera completely through. That were a big fish, that, weren't it?
That last one, and the one before last one, bad. Ah.
You lost it?
Yeah.
Oh, dear.
I wanted that one. I'd seen him come through before. It shows you that it's the same fish coming back, though.
It's a joke, isn't it, when they're like that?
I mean, there's not a lot of bait in there either, is there? See, that's just swimming past. They're not puppet, are they?
Oh, they bothered, all right. You'll get one.
I wasn't sure if that was it brushing it or not.
No, it picked it up, hadn't it?
Yeah. It's just moving slowly, weren't they?
Yeah. Over years, you get to know how you've hooked them, don't you? How they're behaving and that.
Do you feel more confident in deeper margin?
I always have felt confident in deeper margins. It's the shallow margins that do it for me. I sometimes think if you can see the fish, they don't hold as long. Do you know what I mean? Is it under his chin?
I didn't see him. Trouble is, in that spot...
Adam Milandin at ready now to
school. The sun is... Yeah, well, you're proficient at the game.
Well, I won't go that far.
The sun's banging where I'm landing it.
Right, yeah, yeah.
So when he came up, I was a bit blinded.
No, I think it's in his mouth.
Well, it hasn't gone across the lake, so that's a start, isn't it?
Took me up length either, has it, yet?
Not yet. I'll bully that off of him.
Well, you don't bite it off when you get him in.
I wouldn't do that. Would you read that earlier? I always wonder when you get someone else watching what they do.
Is the fish on, Brendan?
Yeah.
That's all that matters. How many times have you been guilty of hitting it earlier and missing bite?
Too many.
Right then, there's some big fish down there now. I don't want to lay it on a bike or like that. That didn't take long at all. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Death roll. Winky neck. Oh, yeah. Me personally, I think the ground bait is better at bringing them in, but it doesn't hold them there. The micros sort of keeps them there once they're there, holds them for longer. So there's no outright winner. That's just only what I've found from today. I'm no expert. Oops, in his mouth. It's in his mouth. That's a big fish. Now, sometimes, if you hook them close to the... Bang, you can get their head up straight away. They don't dart off. So
Let's see if I can do it with this one. No. In an old mice, that won't be a problem because you're keeping that, so then it blocks them from going under your platform. Ooh, turn it round, get it in. Done it, Buster. Well, I think that's last fish of the session. So, well, you've enjoyed the video, guys. I hope to see you again.